I'm Michael Sorg, and this is Just Pro Wrestling News for Saturday, May 29th, 2021. Matt Carlins is on holiday. A special welcome to those of you listening on WrestleMamp.com. If you want to bring our updates to your website, email us at desk@justprowrestlingnews.com.
AEW.
AEW's Double or Nothing pay-per-view is Sunday night. There are five title matches on the card. Kenny Omega defends the AEW Championship in a three-way against Pac and Orange Cassidy. Dr. Britt Baker looks to end Hikaru Shida's one-year reign as AEW Women's Champion. Jon Moxley and Eddie Kingston challenge Young Bucks for the AEW tag titles. Miro puts the TNT Championship on the line against Lance Archer. Plus, Serena Deeb will defend the NWA Women's World Championship on the buy-in pre-show against Riho. Also on the show, the Inner Circle versus the Pinnacle in a Stadium Stampede. If the Inner Circle loses, they must disband. Sting and Darby Allin team up against Scorpio Sky and Ethan Page. Cody Rhodes faces Anthony Ogogo, and Hangman Page goes one-on-one with Brian Cage. On Friday Night Dynamite, in front of a seemingly full-capacity Daily's Place, we saw Darby Allin over Cesar Bononi in the opening match, followed by Dark Order saving Sting and Darby from an attack by Page and Sky. Paul White hosted a weigh-in for Anthony Ogogo versus Cody Rhodes, which didn't end in physicality. Hangman Page defeated Joey Janela, followed by a face-to-face with Page and Cage, where Page asked for this match to be one-on-one without Team Taz involvement. Jade Cargill defeated her challenger Kylan King, but also took on her official new manager, Mark Sterling. Miro successfully defended the TNT title against Dante Martin. Dark Order's Evil Uno and Stu Grayson fell to Ethan Page and Scorpio before being attacked by an army of Stings. The Inner Circle celebration ended with the group being lured into an ambush by the Pinnacle, who kidnapped Dean Malenko. Shaquille O'Neal says that he'll wrestle again this summer. He made the comment during Thursday's NBA on TNT broadcast.
WWE.
WWE has a date set for SummerSlam. It'll be held on Saturday, August 21st. The location is being kept under wraps for now. WWE says it'll be revealed next Saturday on NBC during the Belmont Stakes pre-race show. The SummerSlam announcement was part of a big release of dates and locations for live WWE events over the summer. Some are non-televised super shows. There are also Raw dates now set for Chicago, Orlando, San Antonio, San Diego, Oklahoma City, and Miami, as well as SmackDown dates in Tampa, Tulsa, Oklahoma, Phoenix, Little Rock, Arkansas, and Jacksonville. Tickets go on sale Friday, June 11th. On SmackDown Friday night, the reunited Usos defeated the Street Profits, Natalya and Tamina beat Riot Squad in a 9-title match, Bianca Belair defeated Carmella with Bayley on commentary, Kevin Owens nearly beat Intercontinental Champion Apollo Crews before interference by General Aziz, Nakamura defeated Chad Gable and narrowly avoided losing his crown back to Baron Corbin thanks to Rick Boogs for the save. Dominic Mysterio defended the SmackDown Tag Team Championship solo against Ziggler and Rude after an apparent attack on Rey Mysterio during the break. Rey came out to distract for the win and retain for the duo. The Usos are now set to challenge for the Tag Championships next week on SmackDown.
New Japan Pro Wrestling.
On Friday's New Japan Strong, recent dojo graduate Clark Connors defeated AJZ, El Fantasmo defeated Will Utah, and the Strong Openweight Champion Tom Lawler successfully defended against Chris Dickinson. And finally, due to the extension of the state of emergency and request limited weekend events in Osaka, Japan, Dominion in Osaka Joe Hall has been postponed until Monday, June 7th. That's Just Pro Wrestling News for Saturday, May 29th. Please rate, review, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss our next update. I'm Mike Sorg, and thank you for listening. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.